Effective midnight tonight, the risk-based model for determining the insurance premium that a bank should pay for its deposits annually will take effect. This implies that the current flat rate of 0.15% of deposits paid by all banks will cease to be in place, a move that the Kenya Deposit Insurance Corporation, KDIC, will help boost equity in the banking sector. Alex Mwangi now reports.
It is a transition whose push for implementation has gained momentum ever since the banking sector was rocked by the collapse of Dubai, Chase and Imperial Banks, bringing to visibility the uneven risk profile in the banking sector. The Kenya Deposit Insurance Corporation says the new model will ensure greater equity for banks when it comes to insuring their depositors.
Before this, we used to have what we call flat rate assessment. So all banks were being charged 0.15% of their annual average deposits.
The new risk-based premium assessment model borrows from the internationally renowned CAMELS rating system, meaning banks will pay annual premium based on their capital adequacy, assets, management capability, earnings, liquidity, and sensitivity.
So with the risk-based premium, it is 0.15% plus X, and the X is your risk assessment.
It is now 1 year since the Kenya Deposit Insurance Corporation attained the legal mandate to pay depositors up to an upper limit of ₱500,000 in case a bank fails. Chase Bank depositors were the first to benefit from this revision in the upper limit from ₱100,000 to ₱500,000.
₱500,000 today in our economy, we are protecting 99% of the deposit accounts in our banks.
According to Ahmed, the risk-based premium model will not translate to bigger banks paying more premium.
The previous model, indeed, big banks were really complaining, saying that they are kind of subsidizing for the smaller banks because they are paying higher. But now this model brings in equity. It doesn't matter whether you are big or small. Now, what is the variable, the moving variable here? It is your risk profile.
Nigeria is the only other African country that has already embraced the risk-based premium model for its banks. The new model was developed with support from the World Bank and the US Treasury. Alex Mwangi, NTV.